we're missing two characters, Faye and Ellie. I don't really want Billy. I don't like his guns. I don't like his ammo. I'll keep Bart. I don't know if I'm going to be using gear, so unfortunately, I don't know if I should be using Maria. And I don't have any equipment for Emeralda. And Rico's also not equipped well. No one's equipped well. I gotta try and equip them a bit. Heck, even Bart might be missing some. So at this point, Faye has basically gone and abandoned us in a sense. Hold on a second. A little update here is just taking everything out of... There we go. I didn't want that to happen. Okay. So. Equip. Rico, I need to give him some stuff. Heck, even he needs some good stuff. There's very few places I can buy things anymore. Gold invest is pretty good. Give that to him. King's Helm, okay. What about you? You got a penguin coat. That's from a while ago. Dark armor is the best I can give. A metal helmet he has here. I can only give him a feathered cap. And what about for you here? Power Ring S. A battle apron is better. I guess I'll give you the battle apron then. Gear, I think I need to equip on Bart's. Yep. Just in case, let's get rid of some of this stuff here. Put that back. Wow, that's why I was able to do good against Miang's gear. It gives me 200 plus. There are slated R7. I mean... Seal barrier is probably not needed anymore. So I'll give him... Well, definitely this. How about you? Give him some ether arm, maybe, I guess. What about a recovery? Let's do that. What about you? Did I on steer? Oh yeah, we've lost our, Oh jeez, he needs some better stuff. We've lost our, Omni gears. They've been sucked into Deuce. As have Ellie. So for now, we've lost Ellie to Deuce. I think that's good. For now, because I don't know what to expect. Start. We are now chasing down Faye, who is most probably turned into Id, who is most likely seeking the power, like Lacan did. What is that? Maybe I should have kept Maria on. We're gonna be in our gears. This must be the place. This is where Faye has gone to. Oh. Wait for me! This is as far as you can come. From here on is my world. You can't enter. What do you mean? You're a subordinate. Fake persona. That's why. A subordinate? Fake person? Yes, he has part of my memories from back then. He has sealed away the very meaning of my existence. My drive. My motivation. My subconscious. Id. Because of that, I became a basic blank persona. And on top of that, I constructed a new persona based on my experiences since then. That is what you are now. Him? You mean father? You call him father? He who never did anything for you? It was because of his cowardly behavior. If only he had been able to protect me. If he had done that, Mother wouldn't have died. Didn't my mother die right after I was born? What really happened to my mother? Tell me, Id. You don't need to know. You'll only disappear soon. Along with your basic persona, the coward. I'll rule my being through the power of the existence. Of course you don't know, but it is etched in my metamyphysicotic memory. Wow, I've never seen that word before. Your persona is fake, so you'll never stand on the stage of consciousness. You'll never be able to take charge of the memories from our past lives. I know the dreams and hallucinations. I've seen them many times. Them. I showed them to you on purpose. To break the seal, I chose to weaken the power of your existence. If your mental energy is weakened, I can become free to do as I wish. What? There are still things inside you which you haven't been shown yet. Huh? Someone's coming. It's probably your friends. They must have followed me. Where are you going? I came to re-establish contact with the existence. The existence? That's a new thing they've introduced. To tie together all the threads of your memories since ancient times, and then cut them off. That is the fate of the contact. All is ready. It's time for the true awakening. I will eliminate all those who were full of hypocrisy from the very beginning. Wait! Wait for me, Id! You just stay here and observe. The existence. What type of battle are we going to encounter now? We are obviously going to encounter something. Do we have to fight Id? Id is strong. What is this? Oh yeah, we're supposed to be finding something shocking here. It's something, a gear in there? Faye? This must mean this is Weltall's transformed appearance? Like, this is something that's been hidden away? And is it just trying to eliminate everything, including Deuce? Is that the Slayer of God? Like, face the counter to Deuce? Coming out. More destruction. Well, it's mostly under the earth right now, but every time something awakens, there's always destruction. Those memory cubes? Nice! Just great! What am I going to expect here? Ooh, I don't know. What am I battling? Id? Man, our gear. We don't even have our Omni gears. That's not that strong, I guess. I should use booster. That way I can go fast. Booster seems to be good for stop ether engine. Huh? Whoa, hey! Wow. Well, at least my gears have been upgraded. Be nice if I had the Id power myself. Beat Serpent, go! Yeah, I'm gonna have to give Saiten also that move. Ow, Saiten's taking a lot of hits here. Alright, Bomberhead. Haven't used this in a while. .31, .35. Not too bad. Booster. That way I can at least go a bit faster. It'll use a bit more fuel, but it's worth it, I guess. Man, he's really taking a beating on Saiten for some reason. I don't understand it. Did I already do this? I'm losing track here. Well, everyone will now have their death blow moves. But yeah, I don't have my Omni Gears anymore. Those were sucked into Deuce. I even get to use, Hey, I didn't even get to use Ellie's. I didn't get to use Rico's because I didn't know he'd get one. I didn't get to use Billy's because I don't really use Billy. Might need to give a recovery to him. It's that move he does where he makes them fly around. Ah, I always forget. I like how Billy hasn't taken any damage at all. Alright. So Saiten's now at his death blow while the rest are not. Stop Aether Engine. What is that? Is there something else supposed to be attacking here? No. I don't know what Stop Aether Engine means. Oh well, I'll just continue battling. I've taken away a lot from him. There we go. Oh, Graf? Oh, Wiseman, are you okay? Man, he just pops up out of nowhere. Wiseman! It's already too late. Assist me, for I am about to exterminate Id. Zohar is Deuce's core. The slave generators and ether. It's the source of all their energy. After attaining its power, the freshly awakened Id intends to annihilate this world. The contact with Zohar was meant to have been done after the unifying phase true personality. Huh? Keep back! You again. You were always getting in my way. But I cannot be stopped by you. You, who couldn't even protect his own wife and son. You cannot even bear to show your face to your son. Oh, well, that's a twist I didn't even see coming. Aw, man. So, Wiseman is actually Khan, Faye's father. Jeez, I actually did not even put that together. That's why you wear a mask, isn't it, Khan? Son? That's right. This man is my father, Khan Wong. All this time, Wiseman has been Faye's father in disguise, and yet he referred to Khan in the third person, as though they are separate entities. That's what Khan looks like? What happened to Faye, Id? Too bad. The new personality of Faye that you gave birth to, and all that work that your persona did to make him one, perfect, unified whole has been wasted. He will be swallowed up by me. I won't permit it. I will destroy you first. As if you could, sissy. Mother died because of your cowardly behavior. And as a result, he ran away from that reality by entering into his memories. And now I continue my existence bearing all that hatred. You wouldn't be able to imagine what it's like. I wasn't simply working to unify Faye's personality, you know? All that you and I feel, the sadness, the hatred, even though he also experienced such things. Faye needs to be encouraged to build himself up in order to be able to comprehend all of this. Faye should be able to understand all of your feelings now. But now you want to erase the one who understands you. To kill Faye. What is it that you want? Why ask me such a thing now? My purpose is the same as his. Total destruction. That and that alone. Is this world so bad a place that there is only hatred inside of you? You're the one who made me this way. You and that woman. Admit it. Arr! Fae! Can you hear me? Please take this fistful of memories I am giving you. Become one with yourself and with me. What's with all this unifying stuff? Fae, where did the real you go? Remember, were you not going to help Ellie? Seriously, everyone seems to be unifying. Yes, this is inside Id. A world filled with hatred and sadness. That's all that's here. Yes, now I understand, Id. Why you hate the world. Why there is nothing inside you. Nothing. Nothing was given to you, deprived of, all the happy memories. And yet, it feels pleasant. It almost feels good. Now I get it. There's no need to resist. I was originally just an existence that was created as a cover to hide Id. So it would be better to return to that place. Let's come together. To wipe away everything, including ourselves. Remember, you were not going to help Ellie? Were you not going to help Ellie? Ellie? That's right. Ellie. I've got to save Ellie. What's this place? What's he done now? He only called you in here for his own sake. This is inside the shell of your basic character, the Room of the Coward. I'm sure you've been here many times before. I see, I remember now. In my dreams. Everything despised and unwanted he pushed onto me, while he shut himself up in his own little shell, that coward Fae. The basic for our personalities. Who are you? Ah, you're my... Hey, let's watch this together. This is my most treasured possession. Ha! By repeatedly replaying the times he was full of happiness, he lives in his own happy little world. While I'm still alive only because of what's in those leftover dregs. Here, I'll show you everything about me. 10. Oh boy, a film! I can't believe Fae has film inside of him. With a countdown. This is weird. I've never even known you could film things in this game. Ours was an ordinary family. It always starts out like that. A strict but reliable father. A kind and loving mother. Before I continue on, so we know Faye's mother is Karen. The theory of Karen. She awakened as Miang at one point. That is my theory right now. I'm sticking to it, unless proven wrong. Up till then, it was complete happiness. But one day, Mother suddenly changed. Miang, she was like a totally different person. From that day on, Fae lost his home. Father was away often. He had some important work. Oh, and then Miang, as his mother, did stuff to him. When father was away from home, Fae was taken to a place with mysterious machines. Inside there were many strangely dressed people. Many types of probes were injected into Fae's body as a start to some kind of experiments. The tests caused Fae much pain. Mom, help me! What are you doing? No! No! Mother didn't come to his assistance. Young Fae had no way of resisting, but he was able to endure. Eventually, the experiments became unbearable. Many people gathered around Fae. These people had a high compatibility with the anima relics. This psychic contact with Fae was to force him to awaken. But no one could make contact with Fae. The power drawn out of Fae, regardless of his will, destroyed them all. This is unbelievable. Mother allowed this to take place? Psychic contact? What do you mean by awaken me? To awaken God, Everything had to be in perfect order, with nothing lacking. Things divided in the past must become one complete whole again. Countless people die before Fei's eyes. Men, women, the old, the young, even demi-humans. Suffering, grief, fear, ecstasy, a variety of emotions and words lingered, and tumbled about Fei like broken dolls. It was a scene from hell. In front of Father, she acted normally. When Fei tried to tell Father about Mother's strange conduct and the experiments, Father's mind was taken up by his work and he didn't really listen. He thought it was just childhood fantasies. But he didn't have to endure the pain much longer. Fei's subconscious discovered a way to escape from the trauma. He formed a separate persona to deal with things he didn't like or couldn't bear, and that birthed Id. He removed himself from out of harm's way. My role was to have all the things he hated forced upon me the moment they arose. From the time of my division from him, I was dominated by hatred. That hatred naturally turned into destructive impulses. I wanted to destroy everything. Mother, Father, the entire world. Finally, Father noticed Mother's odd behavior, but it was already too late. I had completely separated from that coward, my original self. The puppets were broken, and Fei's heart was too. What would make Mother do such a thing? Mother repeated the experiments to study the power she knew existed within me. Yes, that woman, Mother, was Miang. That's a lie. No, it's true. Mother was Miang. I guess that much. That's right. Karen had become Miang. What is that you say? It's nothing special. Miang does not have only one host body. Miang's roots are sealed in the genes of all women. Any one of them could become Miang. It just happened to be Mother's turn. Only Ellie was special, originally. No! Karen, Miang noticed that Fei's memory time access had increased 2 or 3-fold. She then became convinced that Fei was the contact. Contact? Yes, I was the contact. That's why he called out to me. And why the time he had come. Stop it! Cut it out! Dad! Dad! Mom, help Dad! Hey, Mom! Why aren't you helping Dad? Dad! Dad's gonna die! Graf came seeking the power that exists within me, to return to his own body. Now, here's one thing I've been kind of mulling over. Why does Fei look exactly like Lacan? Unless there's some sort of relation by blood, there is no reason for Fei to look like Lacan. You understand now, don't you? Graf is Lacan. We, his descendants who inherited his lingering thoughts and memories from him, know only too well. There we go. They're descended from Lacan. Though why he looks exactly like Lacan, I don't know. There. Explained. That's good. Divided 500 years ago, he would become a part of us both. Lacan became Graf. He destroyed everything on the face of the earth. He then mastered how to possess the bodies of others by dwelling in their minds. He was probably enabled to do so after his contact with the existence. The bodies died, but Lacan's spirit continued living by possessing others. So he's the male version of Miang. He had come that day to return his soul, at last, to the perfect reincarnation of his physical body. The body of Fei. Father fought him. But he couldn't protect Mother or I. He pitifully fought on while coughing up his lifeblood. Graf made a mockery of Father and Mother would not even help save him, and Mother would not even help him when he needed her the most. As for their son, he couldn't take what was happening anymore. He gave into his feelings and released his power, and as a result, Mother died. Mom! And he offloaded the results of his actions onto me. To avoid taking the responsibility for killing Mother, he used me as a shield. I also killed Mother. He pushed all the bad things onto me, but kept all the memories filled with happiness and Mother's love to himself. And he shut himself away with those memories inside his own little shell forever. This is the place. What you see before you is what he made. He just keeps hanging onto those memories. That's what this is. Stop it. Just stop it. These scenes. Are these all there is to you, to us? Enough already. There is nothing here. Just a world filled with deception and pain. It can't be helped. This is our world. This is everything. I was a fool. It was all my fault. I was so busy with my duties and Shevet that I didn't notice Karen had changed. I couldn't save you when you needed my help. Save me? Ha! Why bother saying such nonsense now? It's not going to change anything. The only thing you can do now is die by my hand. Ugh! Even still, I'll show you that I can't save you. Dad! Stop it, Id! Father has done nothing wrong. I know. This one is the real culprit. Mother and Father had no choice. Oh. Look. I'm in the past. Thanks, pass it back to me. I'm playing with Mother. This is not reality. It's all fake, it's all a trick, all of it, all of it, all of it! The text went so fast I didn't have time to read it. No, get out! This is my room. I thought you would always be with me. Why won't you see reality? Happiness, sadness, aren't these all parts that combined to make the whole? Why won't you show him? Why don't you also show Id what you always watch? No, that's mine. I don't want to show it to the person who killed Mother. You should talk. You're the one who killed Mother. No, I didn't. You did. I did not kill her. Mother didn't care for you. Father didn't know us either. That's why you killed her. I didn't kill her. I didn't. Knock it off. We killed Mother. It's no one's fault but ours. It's not because she became Yang or because Father didn't notice. Don't look outside for the reason. Don't blame anyone but yourself. Yes, Mother was Yang, and I know that you suffered. No one could have endured it. But you can't push it onto it alone. We are all one person. We must all become one. Right, Fei? Walk on your own two feet. Face up to the reality that you don't want to see. Show them to Id everything you took for yourself. Huh. So it came from his mother, that thing. Why did she have that? Lies! That woman! This scene! All illusions he made up! I, my consciousness, can see through this trick. I won't be swayed. I... Id, that's enough. Doing that isn't going to solve anything. Mother saved us at the last moment. That is the truth, right? The reality isn't all grim, Id. My power couldn't save anyone. It only destroyed. I thought that I could only make a connection with others through destruction. So I had to destroy it all. People, the world, even Ellie. No, that's not the case. We can save others just as Mother despite being Miang, saved us. Our power can save people. We can save Ellie. That's a first, Mother being so warm. To me, she almost seems too warm. Faye, take the memories I have within me. You must know what it used to be like up until now. Know our identity, about who we are, then figure out what ought to be done. Our integration is not yet complete. Hey look, Emperor Kane. Ellie? When is this? Elhaim! Abel, live. Okay. So apparently... Oh, hey, look. Emeralda. Well, there goes Ellie again. I just can't hand our child over to you. Live. And of course, Sophia and Lacan. So basically, Faye and Ellie have been living together since, like, what, the beginning of time? And every time, Ellie's incarnation has always died, and Faye's lived on. Lacan, live. What a screwed up past that is. If God doesn't exist in our world, then I will create God with my own hands. What is this place? My execution site? Why do you turn on me? I thought we were friends. Who is it? Did I cause this? What has happened to me? What have I become? Live! I will live. Even if I go to hell, I will live till the end of this world. If the world does not come to an end, I will destroy it with my own hands. I'm telling you, Graf's gotta be somewhere near the final boss, considering... Faye, who is it? Who's calling me? I am... Har... What is this light? I reside in Zohar. I am the beginning and the end, the first and the last. God? God. Some refer to me as that from a certain point of view. It is right to view me as such, but at the same time, I am not. I am also a part of you. A part of me? I am defined by how people observe me. You are actually talking to a virtual version of me that you yourself create. I am your perception of me. I don't understand what you are talking about. Who or what are you? In one word, existence. Existence? In actuality, I do not have a physical form. I am an existence of a higher dimension, a place you cannot perceive, but in the terms you understand, it is a world where everything acts as kinds of waves. It is the source of this four-dimensional universe, the place where time and space is controlled, the fluctuating void, the wave existence. What does such an existence have to do with me? Long ago, a modifier, or a pseudo-perpetual infinite energy engine was created. That engine was named Zohar. That reactor was created by an ancient people from another planet to attain what is considered to be the ultimate energy possible within this four-dimensional universe. Eventually, those people used the same engine to create the ultimate interplanetary invasion weapon, Deuce. Zohar was used as its primary source of power. But the unexpected happened. During the connection tests of Zohar with the newly completed Deuce, the engine started to examine infinite potential phenomena. Requiring energy, the engine connected this dimension to the higher dimensional space. As a result, that reactor merged or synchronized with the wave existence in that higher dimension, me. I descended from the point of contact created by the machine through the path of Sephiroth, or the domain you are in right now, and incarnated in the four-dimensional world. After I advented to the four-dimensional world, in order to stabilize myself there, here, I had to exchange or materialize my form and enter into the modifier engine. In other words, I became bound in Zohar, the cage of fleshly existence. Since the time I was bound in Zohar, I have always wanted to return to my own dimension, and I came to a conclusion. I had to reverse the process I went through to arrive here. I must be released by one who installed within me a special feature of this dimension, the will. That one is you. Decided it was me, a special feature? Yes, I was given a special attribute of a human by you, the contact. When you observed me, I was given a mother's will. A mother's will? I'm sure you remember. After my descent, you had contact with the modifier engine, Zohar. As a contact, being but only a child, you define my existence with your desire to return to your mother. Thus, I came to prepare the mother's will. That will is Elhaim. Ellie's disposition was influenced by me? Yes, my will was incarnated through a biocomputer which was developed for Deuce. After combining with me, the biocomputer evolved its functions, and that bioplan generated a central element. That is her. I was split by your contact. My physical form or flesh stayed in Zohar, while my will went to Elhaim, and my power went to you. That's why I waited to unite with you, and now it is fulfilled. My only remaining desire is to break this cage of fleshly existence. In order to do that, I must become perfect by combining with Elhaim, as well as my other split physical form, Deuce. The only way to return to my original dimension is to destroy this physical body. In the four-dimensional world, Zohar is perfect, so in order to destroy Zohar, I need the strength that was attributed to you. Zohar can only be destroyed by the hands of the contact. What about Ellie? If Zohar is destroyed, what will become of Ellie? Zohar and Deuce are one. She's bound to the system by another's will to become one with me. In order to release her, it is necessary to destroy that very system that serves as the Deuce weapon. However, having been created as a weapon, the Deuce system seeks to unify itself with all of you for a different purpose than that of mine. Originally, her release should have been performed by me, the one who desires to return back to the higher dimension. But I am also bound to the system just as she is, so I am unable to participate. A lot of reading. You are the only one who can release her from the spell. Just as Deuce and I are inseparable, you and her are also inseparable. All right, I'll destroy Deuce and the Zohar modifier, and I'll save Ellie. You have experienced much loss and deprivation in your life. It is very tragic. Our contact and the resulting transference of power and will between you and I most likely played a factor in splitting your personality. I disagree. I can't blame anything or anyone besides myself. Regardless of what may have happened in the past, with the passing of time, the cause becomes more remote. It is a problem that comes from within myself, that I myself must deal with. I see. You have managed to accept those tragedies, tolerate all things, to comprehend and find where you stand in this world. If you have succeeded to do all these things, I am sure you will succeed in what awaits you now. To liberate all of us, use the Xenogears. Destroy Zohar. Wait, there's more I need to ask you. The system is awakening. Ask her later. Save your data. Save. Still 20 minutes left that I can do up to. So basically, well, you saw what happened. I don't need to go over it. So all of Faith's personalities should be merging, and he must use the Xeno Gears. Resume. What are the Xeno Gears? Well, it's the title of the game. But what are they in actuality? Maybe I'll be getting the Xeno Gear for Faye. For what? That's his Xeno Gear? Dad! Dad, are you okay? Dad, I'm sorry. This is all my fault. Faye, you've returned to your own self. You've become one. Yes, thanks to you all. If all you hadn't called out to me. Urgh. Dad! Don't worry. This is good. This is, after all, I... Dad? You and I must become one. Huh? Graf? What's going on? Haha! I reached the limit of the body I possessed on that day 3 years ago. I required a body that would tide me over until your true awakening. That is why I acquired the body of your father. Regardless of your awakening, your merging and the inherited memories you had acquired. There was no way for you to know of this, since you had lost your memory at that point. At the point in which I merged with your father. Impossible. What about Wiseman? What about father? Of course they were just parts of me. I couldn't hold on to Khan totally. His ego was far stronger than I imagined. When my control weakened, he showed himself to you as wise man. Urgh. You have awakened. This body is now useless to me. Now I must return to my original body, the reincarnation of my body that you inhabit. Stop it, Dad. I hear you, Faye. You see, he and I are one. I am Khan. Khan is me. He has become one with me, so you too should open your heart and unite with me. Then we can go on to eliminate everything. No. I can't allow you to control me. There's a floating Fae. I have to fight his gear. Protecting your master? Then so be it. I'll merge with both you and your machine then. Now come, Fae, fight me. It's no use. I know you're Lacan and that you're a part of me. But that doesn't change your being my father. I could never really fight you. You're so naive. Why don't you understand that your naivety is what killed Sophia, what killed your mother, Karen? I already know that. That's why I swore never to run away again. That I must rescue Ellie, so don't get in my way. Wake up. Open your eyes, Father, Lacan. If that's the case, then fight me. Fight me. I can't. I see. Then there's no choice. Since you are so unwilling to fight, I believe I'll have to use them as bait. Uh-oh. Stop it! Don't we have the same memories? Can't you also remember that sadness you felt way back then? Why then? Why must you destroy everything? If we stop Deuce, won't this all be over? You still don't understand, even after your contact with the existence? I came to understand after my contact with the existence that even if Deuce was destroyed, as long as humans still inhabit this land, Miang, Elohim, will be born time and again. Then all living things may as well perish along with Deuce itself. That's the only path to freedom. The path to release us from the eternal cycles of life, the tragedies of history, and the spell of fate. Once I awaken Deuce as a weapon, I'll obliterate all living things. Then I'll use your awakened self and that machine to return everything to nothing. That's what I concluded. Miang and Elohim are not just Deuce's mouthpieces. That woman is its main body. Why can't you see that? That's not true. She gave her life for me by shielding me from harm. Her eyes were Miang's. Mother came back at the last moment. Miang, Mother, even Ellie were all humans born on this planet. Deuce doesn't matter. You'll see. I'll bring Ellie back. Father. No, Graf. Lacan. If you won't back down... Never! Then I have no choice. The time has come to truly become one. Ooh, a new gear. Let's see how this goes. True Welltall. Nice. 780. 1560. Whoa, hey, wait, I got like 30,000 HP here. Okay, let's see what this goes like. 39. Apparently, True Welltall's not as good as, well, whatever Graf has. Options. Fixed frame only. Attack. I got Repu. 2550. I don't know. He's a lot stronger than me. I know I have a lot more fuel, though. Maybe I should booster. Only uses 140 fuel. Jeez. This guy. Miss. How am I supposed to fight him if he's so much better than me? 2400. I mean, at least I have enough fuel to recover if I need. But I mean, he's definitely stronger than me. He's also faster. Oh, there we go, 803. Why did I only do 39 that one time? I don't get why I only did 39 that time with X. Well, I still got 20,000 left. Miss. Repu. 2500. ...1500... ...2300... I am not at that point. 200! That did more than the other one. Whatever. 2400... So I don't get... What's with Welltall? He's trans... He has so many transformations. It's unbelievable sometimes. Let's try Square. 404. That's decent enough. I seem to go faster when I got my Deathblow move, I notice. There we go. No! Gah! Oh, Graf's down. First time I'm actually able to beat him straight on. Well, in his gear, that is. What about Proto Welltall? Was that just a one-time thing? Why don't you finish me off? If you don't get rid of me, then you cannot get what you want. It's alright, Dad. I understand. You are not Graf. You are my father, and you and Graf are one. Your will and purpose never change. I knew that once we fought. Let's stop now. Our objective should be the same. It is the same as our becoming one. We don't have to fight. What? What? My body! Zohar is after you. The last piece to combine it with Dude's system. It seeks to unify with you. The first to have been divided from it. What? This is what Lacan wanted all along. After all, I'm an imperfect existence. It was inevitable that it would come to this, considering what had happened in the past. Lacan's imperfect secondary contact with the wave existence split his personality into two. Eventually his body died, but the original Lacan transmigrated, bringing the destiny of becoming a contact with him. He was reborn as your present body. The remaining persona, just his desires, lived on separately by possessing the bodies of others. That is Graf. That is me. I may have inherited Lacan's will, but I'm not the same as the contact Lacan. It is impossible for me to make real contact. There would be no true melding and release. Even though our bodies may be different, I am still half of you. That fact remains. Although I'm imperfect, I can merge temporarily with Zohar, and thus may be able to buy some time, you some time. This is the only way I can be one with you. This is all I can do. Deuce's system will start to look for you again. Before then, you have to destroy the newly perfected Deuce and the Zohar modifier. You're the only one that can destroy the physical barrier that encases God's body. Dad! As you said, that was Karen. Through many generations, Miang is beginning to break free from her bounds. Now that Elhaim has merged with Deuce, she has all of her memories back. All the memories from her original birth as the contact's completement up to the her current transmigration. That includes all the lives she has lived as Miang and her substitutes over the centuries. And of course, that includes your mother's memories too. Mother's memories? Faye, cut away all the binds on mankind. You should be able to do that now. Save her and all the other women bound with her. I'm begging you, Faye. Oh, Graf's not such a bad guy. He's been trying to kind of help out, but in not so great ways. What's this? This pendant. Is this Sophia's or my mother's? It's nothing. I'm just talking to myself. I'm sorry for all the trouble I've caused everyone. Thank you all so much. Anyway, let's get going. There's little time left now, for me and for our planet. So Ellie now has all the memories also. What is this place? This is where it all started. This is our genesis. Humans were born here. Long ago, Deuce crash-landed on this planet in an interplanetary colony ship. In order to revive itself someday, Deuce attached the Zohar modifier's core. After this core unit came down here, a single woman awoke and arose from out of it. She's the mother of all humanity. After she awoke, she used all her power to bear several beings. These would become the ancestors of the whole of humanity. These were the Emperor and the Gazelle Ministry. Finally, she gave birth to replicas of herself to be humanity's caretakers. Two selves, the human mother and the weapon, the subject and the completement. That is Ellie and Miang. I, the sole survivor from the colony ship, met Ellie and... Wait, a survivor? And everything started from there. The land of Genesis, Kadamoni, this is that place. Yeah, but Faye, even with your shared fate with Deuce, why do you have such ancient memories? Usually, human memories cannot be passed down through the generations. Humans do not normally have the ability to compress and store memories in their introns. But Ellie and I, and Miang, are different. Due to our connection with the wave existence, that is, due to Zohar's ability to change possible phenomena, we can clearly store data in our introns. In other words, we can leave behind memories to be inherited by our descendants. Just as the wave existence is bound inside of Zohar, the information is affixed to me, so to speak, by some of the power of the wave existence. Well, this is explaining all the questions I had now. What's in there? Then this is the form from when Ellie and Miang were still one being. This is the first woman of our world. You mean that long-haired nude woman that appeared? Our mother. Well, everyone's back together. So if we destroy that Zohar thing, everything will be over, right? Yes. The source of our ether powers and the source of power from the generators that make our gears work. It all comes from the Zohar modifier engine, which can control any potential phenomena. If we destroy it, Deuce and the Seraph Angels will all be deactivated. And then we should be able to free Ellie, who has become bound to the Deuce weapon system as Miang. Right, Faye? Yeah, that's what the wave existence said. But then there is the downside. It will also mean that we will no longer be able to use our gears or our ether powers anymore. What are those Seraph Angels all about anyway? That odd appearance as if they lack something, as if they were neither living beings nor mere weapons. Zohar senses the human consciousness and interacts with the Seraphs. Human consciousness? Zohar itself involves the principle of uncertainty. The observer's perception of Zohar determines the entity it actually becomes. In other words, I believe that those angels are incarnations of the spirits of people. The people who have been absorbed by Deuce to become parts of it. So what merit is there for them to gain in eliminating all civilization? Is it some kind of hatred for those humans who have survived? Of course not. Those people who were created and assimilated as parts for Deuce would not have such intentions. Try to remember what Ellie, when she became Miang, said. The creations of God will someday be a hindrance. That is why they must be eliminated. Yes, that is why Merkava is being used to begin the destruction. But Deuce is not following its programming to exterminate all civilization. The Seraphs, which are terminal interface weapons of Deuce, are using their bodies composed of nanomachines to absorb massive numbers of people regardless of whether they are dead or alive. It is not discriminating between the mutant and non-mutant people. This is highly peculiar. The fact that the people who are meant to be destroyed are being taken in as well. That is the absolute opposite of what it is supposed to be doing. Maybe there aren't enough parts? That is unlikely. Aside from those bodies that were destined to be parts for it. Deuce, who has already acquired the ability of the nanomachines, can just about use any material to construct its body. His eyesight has other intentions in mind. Those intentions, Krillin has called Deuce the Mother. If God is the Mother, then those moments are coming from the Great Mother, impeding the growth of its child, enveloping it to bring the child back to the womb to become one with it. That is its motive. Such program does not exist within its design, though. It was probably given this unique will by someone, either from Ellie, who has merged with Deuce, or... Either way, it doesn't change the fact that we have to fight. Regardless of what their intentions are, the problem is now we're supposed to deal with them. You think we can do it in our current state? This secret battleship Excalibur will also take part in the final battle. And additionally, the military potential of all the surface forces will assemble here. Even if we can put together a massive force, we still have the problem with the main armament of the Merkava. We need to know how to take that out. As long as we don't do that... Merkava's ultra-long-range cannon has the ability to vaporize any substance. On top of that, they have a barrier around their perimeter that nullifies all attacks. We've fought against the Merkava many times to try to stop its onslaught. However, we cannot even get close, hence we had to withdraw every time. Damn it, no matter how much we want to save Ellie, if we can't get inside the Merkava, it's meaningless. To add to that, there is the problem of those Seraphs. They function as terminal interface weapons for close defense. I can easily say their attack power is equivalent to the Omnigear class. They even have the regenerative ability due to the nanomachines. Don't be concerned about that. I was able to obtain some data from Xenogears. You see, Xenogears has mutagenically evolved due to its contact with Zohar. Using that data, all of your new gears ought to be completed soon. Additionally, all the other weapons and arrayments are being modified to implement the disassembler device. Disassembler device? In contrast to the nano-assemblers which create matter to repair with, the disassemblers have the ability to dismantle and destroy or destroy matter. They can even deactivate the nanomachines, restoring ability by disengaging their repair programs. This should be sufficiently effective even against the Deuce Seraphs. Alright, even if we can deal with the Angels, just how are we going to deal with that Merkava? We can't even get close to the thing. There is no such thing as a perfect defense. There is a way. Look over here. Was it a single vent that we need to shoot into? Merkava's main gun requires a 1.2 second interval to reload because of its tremendous output. Upon firing, although it is only sectional, there will be a portion of the barrier that will be opened. There is a 1.87 second delay before the barrier reforms in that area. If we can use this window of time to target and destroy that cannon, it will be possible to close in on it. If we can get close enough, we can break through with gravitational spatial correction. Well, this is the rough idea. Unfortunately, we don't have such a long-range cannon. That could acquire a target in such a brief time frame. So what you're saying is, we just need to shut that annoying cannon up, right? You want to go on ahead into Merkava? Now you're being reckless again. That's suicide. No, listen, we're not going to just rush in. The Yggdrasil 4 and this Excalibur are also equipped with barriers that's what we'll use. Although only for a short time, we can withstand a direct hit from Merkava's main cannon. Then we can close in and watch for that part of the barrier to go down and then destroy the cannon. How long will our barrier last? About 20 or so seconds. That's all? It wouldn't matter how fast we fly. In that amount of time, we will be without a barrier before we can get within firing range. And those numbers are valid only if the generator is at full drive, right? We can only get those numbers if we sacrifice all other output from propulsion. I'm not suggesting we go in with guns blazing knowing we're going to lose. We're going to physically put a lid on it, directly. As you said, the Yggdrasil 4 or Excalibur barrier can't sufficiently defend against Merkava's attack. At least with one generator, that is. Meaning, we can defend against the Merkava with twice the amount of time. 40 seconds if we couple two generators together. This way we can make it into the heart of Merkava. Then, what about the propulsion? Just hear me out. This is what we do. First, we transform my Yggdrasil into heavy assault mode and load it into the Excalibur so we can couple the generators. By doing that, we can reduce the energy usage down to just supporting the hull of the ship and generating the barrier. This will allow most of the energy to be devoted to generating the barrier. Next, shift the barrier to full front and focus it to a single point where their main cannon will make its strike. Now for movement. First off, we develop a barrier by engaging Excalibur's generator to maximum power. For propulsion during that time, we'll install on the Yggdrasil those large solid rockets we got from the ruins of the mass driver. When Excalibur's barrier expires, we'll use the Yggdrasil's force generator to develop a barrier. Then we'll also detach the solid rocket and shift the Excalibur into conventional flight. Using this method, we can get right in Merkava's face. After it fires, it'll be defenseless. During this time, we'll block the muzzle of the Merkava's cannon with Excalibur's bow ram, upon which we should have 0.67 seconds. With the cannon fire of the Excalibur, we'll destroy the Yggdrasil force slave generator and incapacitate the Merkava along the way, and then we break through! Sounds complicated. That's what the plan is all about. The combination of the barriers of both ships storming the Merkava, the timing of the cannon fired of the Excalibur, these are all going to be crucial. Mess up any one of these and the consequences are going to be severe. Hence, it'll be necessary to have both crews in sync with each other. That's why I'd like to place Sig in command of the Excalibur. I have no qualms with that. What do you think, Queen? Will you lend us your battleship? Since there appears to be no other alternative, I will go with that. Please use it as you see fit. But are we not cutting it uncomfortably close? When you calculate the arrival time and the barrier generation time, you will also see what I mean. One minor mishap will put us in a situation where we could run out of barrier power before our arrival. Also, we will be devoting both generators to keeping the barriers up. Won't that leave us without perimeter defenses? We won't stand a chance if we get engaged by Seraph Angels on our way to Merkava. We'll hold them off. You can count on us. You guys just concentrate on taking out that main cannon. Thanks. We're depending on you. Alright, everywhere else has been taken out. This is the only place that's left. This is going to be the true final battle. So I guess I won't be having Ellie for the final battle. Because we won't get her back until we kill everything. We set out to silence God's Ark, Merkava, which was the epitome of offensive and defensive power, and then storm inside. We initiated the operation to destroy Zohar. Well, that was quick. Oh, here we go. Will I have to fight any of those things? Next chance I get, I'll end this part. So the barrier is taking the brunt of the hit with all the generators combined, and then as soon as it stops, it's supposed to clog it. This should deactivate the main gun cannon thing, right? And then when we see the barrier, we can sneak in. Wait, what? We got a gear piloting the Yggdrasil piloting a gear. What just shot that? What? You think we just destroyed Merkava or something? Or did we just destroy defensive flying power? And now we can go into it? That can't be! I secondary explosion? Oh no, I should have known better. What a miscalculation. The explosion was too big. It reacted with the main condenser right under the main cannon and induced the secondary explosion. How could I have been so stupid? You mean, we overdid it? Why did I not realize it sooner? This means we might have... Oh no, Ellie! Oh my gosh, Ellie! What is it, this time? Hey, Saiten, what more is going to happen? Something is happening in the center of Merkava. What could it be? They overdid it. I did not expect that to happen. Let me guess, it's... What? Is that Deuce? Oh, what? It's solidifying the entire planet. It's like a Medusa's bug thing. Well, for Reboot. That's what it reminds me of. At that time, the Earth quaked and shook, and from the location where the Merkava crashed, a giant object appeared. It was Deuce's final form. The Merkava was merely its vessel. Deuce evolved through the use of Krillian's nanomachines into a planetary-scale weapon and began terraforming. It was attempting to convert this entire planet into a weapon. We retreated back to the base at the Snow Plains to form a new strategy. We decided to go back into Deuce. This time, the time was running for us. I read that wrong. Well, that plan didn't go well, apparently. Alright, so what's gonna happen now? What of Ellie? Is she now fully formed with Deuce, and the only way to get her back is to finally beat Deuce? I don't know. That's something we might have to find out next part. What's gonna happen? We're forming a strategy. Anyways, informative part. Next time, we'll see what happens.